أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة لأهل التقوى واليقين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، خاتم النبيين نبي القاسم محمد. وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المأسومين، لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين، روحي وارواح العالمين لتراب مقدمه الفدا، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله الحكيم في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: الله أعلم حيث يجعل رسالته. صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلوات. There are two occasions that we are going to be commemorating tonight, and I'll be speaking in English for about 20 minutes about Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam, and then tonight is also the night of the Shahadat of Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam. I'll talk about the fifth Imam al-Islam in Urdu, and then a few words of Masab at the end. There are many different dimensions of the life of Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam which are to be discussed. We believe that the Almighty, when He created this universe, He created the Imams as Imams, and He created everything else for them. However, when they come to this world, it takes a course of time before they take the role of leadership or the role of Imamat. And at any one time, there is only one leader. The Holy Prophet was a leader, and Imam Ali alayhi salam, Imam Hassan alayhi salam, Imam Hussain alayhi salam, they were all followers of the Holy Prophet. And when Imam Ali alayhi salam was the Imam or the leader, then Imam Hassan and Imam Hussain were both followers. When Imam Hassan was the Imam, Imam Hussain was also his follower. Now, the youngest Imam to acquire the status of leadership, when he was leading as an Imam, was Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam. He took the role of Imamat at the age of 7, and then Imam Ali Naqil Islam at the age of 9, and the 12th Imam at the age of 5. And these were the Imams, but the first one of them is Imam, the 9th Imam, who took the Imamat, and he was only 7, and this was the topic of discussion at the time when the Imam alayhi salam became or took the Imamat, the leadership role in his time. And all Shia started discussing that the Imam is not even baligh. Can he be an Imam when he's not even a baligh, or when he is not even an adult? And this was the topic of discussion in the time of the 9th Imam al-Islam, where many different Shias got together in Iraq, in Basra, in Kufa, in Baghdad, in Medina, and they were all discussing one thing, that can the Imam take the role? And then the Imam himself was asked the question that, how are you a divine leader? How are you a hujjat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And many reasons that the Imam al-Islam gave, and you all know the famous debate between him and Yahya ibn Aksam. I'll really quickly touch upon the traveling of Ma'mun that you have all heard. When he was, Ma'mun was a murderer of Imam Ali ibn Musa ar-Raza alayhi salam, and because he had committed such a big crime, he did not have peace of mind. He knew that he is seeing hell, he is going to hellfire. And continuously in his dreams, he would see that angels are telling him that we will take you to the hell and will punish you there. Now, he had this feeling that because he is going to be in punishment and chastisement, how should he have the peace and tranquility? So he asked one of his doctors at the time, what should I do to have peace of mind? And the doctor said to him that you should go for hunting. It diverts your attention and that would give you peace of mind. So he would go for hunting quite often. One day when he was leaving, he saw that there are children playing in Baghdad, and the mother of Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam had moved to Baghdad with him after the Shahadat of Imam Reza alayhi salam. Now, Ma'amun, as he's passing by, his guards announce that the king is coming or the Khalifa is coming and everyone should be careful, and all the children start to run away. And Ma'amun notices that there is a child standing on the side who is very young, about 8-9 years of age, and he does not run away. So he quickly gets off his horse and says, "Son, why haven't you run away?" The Imam al-Islam said, "For 3 reasons I have not escaped." You see, this is now not the talk of a child. He straight away realizes that when the Imam responds to him saying, "I have not run away for 3 reasons," he pays attention. What reasoning does he have? He said, "Number one, I'm not blocking your way in this street. I'm standing on the side, I'm not blocking the way, so I should not be in need of running away from you. Secondly, I'm quite optimistic about you. I have husnadhan about you. I am quite optimistic that you will not kill infallibles and innocent people. Or have you been doing that?" He indirectly indicated that you have killed my father. "And thirdly, I am innocent. I am infallible. I am masoom. I have not committed any sin. Then why should I run away from you? If I have no crime, then I should not run away." He noticed that this child is not an ordinary child. He said, "Who are you? What's your name?" He said, "Ana Muhammad ibn Ali. I am Muhammad ibn Ali. I am Muhammad, son of Ali." He said, "Which Ali is your father?" He said, "Ali ibn Musa ar-Ridha alayhi salam." Straight away, Ma'mun realizes that he is the son of a special father. Nevertheless, he went off for hunting and he came back very quickly. I'm just mentioning this. When he came back, he had sent an eagle behind a small bird, a durraj, like a quail, like a bird. So he sent off this eagle and it comes back with a small fish in its beak. So he thinks, "What's going on? I sent the eagle behind a quail, a bird, and it comes back with a fish." He asked all the people that were in his team, "How come the eagle brought back a fish?" They said, "We don't know." He said, "Okay, anyway, when I go back in my museum in Baghdad, just place this fish and write that this is a fish that Ma'mun Khalifa's eagle brought from the air, and there was no river." Now, when he came back, he was continuously thinking about this fish. Where did it come from? When he reached back Baghdad, his people started announcing that the king or the Khalifa has come back, and all the children started to run away. Again, he saw that there is a young boy, same Imam Muhammad al-Islam, young boy standing there, and he is holding the ear of a goat and continuously saying to the goat, "Usjud lillah, do sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." He said, "Stop, I want to talk to this boy." He got off his horse and he said, "Son, are you playing with this goat?" He said, "Wama khuliqna lillahi wal la'ib. We have not been created for playing and wasting our time." From an ayah from the Holy Quran, so he converted the ayah into his speech. He turned around and said, "Then what are you doing with this goat?" He said, "In childhood, making the animals that are disobedient to Allah obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a game of our childhood. When we grow up, we turn tyrant kings like you into obedient servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." As soon as he said this, he turned around and said, "Are you warning me?" He said, "I'm not. I'm just saying that, are you zalim? I'm asking you, are you zalim that I would need to do this to you?" Ma'mun just quickly did not ask any other questions in case the Imam responded with those strong words again. So his people were listening. He quickly placed his hand in his pocket and took out the fish. And he said, like many people play with the children, "What do I have in my hand?" So he placed the fish in his hand and he said, "What's in my hand?" The Imam al-Islam said, "Many rulers go for hunting and they send their eagles behind birds, and when there are special floods in the rivers and oceans, many times small fish cannot take the strong hold into the water and they go into the evaporation because of that special evaporation of water. And when they are in the air, the eagle leaves the bird and goes and grabs the fish. And when the eagle brings back the fish to the king, he comes and tries the zurriyat of the Holy Prophet, the Ahlul Bayt of the Holy Prophet, and says, "What is in my hand?" Straight away he knew that this child has now told me the entire story that I have been through. He said, "I'll find out," to one of his people, he said, "Find out where he lives. I want to invite him over to my place, to my palace." And then he invited all of the Bani Abbas and said, "I'm marrying my daughter to Imam Ahmad Taqi alayhi salam." And Umm Hakam, he married his daughter Umm Hakam to Imam Ahmad Taqi alayhi salam. And that created a big fuss, that why did he marry the princess to a child? He said, "He's not an ordinary child, he's a special person, he's gifted." And then all of Bani Abbas gathered to question the Imam al-Islam. And Yahya ibn Aksam came and he asked. And you know the famous debate that happened between Yahya ibn Aksam and the Imam al-Islam. And after that, Yahya became quite jealous of the Imam al-Islam. If you want me to mention very quickly the debate, I think the time is short. I'll not go into the debate of Imam al-Islam with Yahya ibn Aksam. You have all heard this famous debate of Imam al-Islam with Yahya. Yahya ibn Aksam was 70 years old man. He was the most learned mufti of the time, most learned scholar of his time, and he was brought to the presence of Ma'mun, and Ma'mun said, "Ask questions from Imam Ahmad Taqi alayhi salam." He gave a pulpit, a member, to Imam Ahmad Taqi alayhi salam. Imam sat down on the member at the age of 9, and Yahya asked him question about Hajj, about Ihram, these are the days, and Imam Ahmad Taqi alayhi salam answered him in a lot of detail that your question is incomplete. He said, if a person is in the haram, he performs hunting, then what is a kafara? What is the penalty of the hunting? The Imam al-Islam said, your question is incomplete. And he gave him 13 questions out of that one question. 13 questions out of that one question that he had asked. And for each one, he mentioned a different kafara. Ma'mun asked him, "Is there for each one?" He said, "Yes." And from those 13, he explained the kafaras of the 13 different states of a muhrim who performs hunting. After that, Yahya ibn Aksam had become quite jealous of the Imam al-Islam. He was envious and asking questions on and off to put down the Imam al-Islam. And he one day said, "How can you be a divine Imam? How can you be sent by Allah? How can Allah choose you to be an Imam? You're not even baligh." The Imam said, "Do you believe in the Holy Quran?" He said, "Yes, I believe in the Holy Quran." The Imam al-Islam said, "Isn't there an ayah in the Holy Quran that says, 'Wa'atayna hukman sabiyya,' and we gave hukum of nabuwwat to Yahya ibn Zakariya when he was only a child, not even baligh. Sabi, saad baya. Sabi is basically applied to a child that has not reached puberty yet, a child who is very young." He said, "Have you not read this ayat that Hazrat Yahya ibn Zakariya was not even baligh when Allah made him a prophet?" He said, "Yes, it's true." He said, "The Allah who can make Yahya and Isa alayhi salam prophets, anbiya, when they are very young, then how can he not make me an imam when I am young? How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make me an imam? I'm a divine imam." He said, "What's the proof that you're a divine imam?" And there are many questions that the imam answered. And very quickly, I just want to answer one or two. He asked the Imam al-Islam, he said, "Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not say about Shaykhain, about the first two khulafa, to the Holy Prophet, did he not say that, 'Ask the two khulafa that I am pleased with them. Are they pleased with me?'" Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not, this is the hadith of the Holy Prophet, so do you not believe in this hadith about Shaykhain, about the first two khulafa, that Allah asked his messenger, the Holy Prophet, asked the first, Shaykhain, "I am pleased with them. Are they pleased with me?" The Imam al-Islam was put in this position with thousands of people in the palace. The Imam said, "Let me ask you a few questions. And what happens in the heart and mind of a person does not know if the two khalifas are pleased with him or not?" This is a question that you have asked and you have put Tawheed under question mark. He said, then what's the answer? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the secrets of the hearts of every person. He would never ever ask the Holy Prophet, ask someone that if they are pleased with me or not. It is Allah's pleasure that is more important, not the pleasure of people with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People can be angry and displeased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for little things. Ya Allah, why did I lose my car? I'm not happy with you. Little things and people become displeased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, that is not sufficient. The pleasure of Allah is the most important. And if Allah, do you think, was pleased, then why should he ask about the Shaykhain? If he wasn't pleased, then it doesn't make a difference if the Shaykhain was pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or they were not pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Imam alayhi salam in depth went into all the different questions. Allama Majlisi has mentioned that 16,000 questions were asked in a few weeks or in a few days from Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali. And he only took a break for wajib namaz or just a little few hours of rest, and all of the time he spent answering the questions of the people, because all over Iraq people were asking the Imam alayhi salam the questions that they were feeling the need and urge to ask, because they had heard that there is a 9-year-old boy who answers every question. Tashayyu, or the path of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, went to Iran through Imam Ali ibn Musa Raza alayhi salam, and tashayyu came to Iraq because of Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salatu wasalam. Because of these two imams, Iran and Iraq became Shias. Imam Ali alayhi salam, he had a lot of people who were fighting against him in Iraq, and then likewise Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein, and then the other imams did not come, and Imam Musa Kazim spent most of his life in the prison. But it was only the 9th imam who had a chance to speak to the people, to converse with the people, and to convert the people to the path of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. And this is what he did. He gave the chance to all people to ask questions. Now, how is it possible to answer 16,000 people of their questions in a few days, in let's say a week or less? Now, Allah Almighty says that many times the Imam did not even listen to the question of the people. I'll give you very quickly an example. One example, as the time is short. 4 people came from the same village and they came to Baghdad and said, we want to ask a question. There was a long queue and the Imam was answering the questions and telling the people to move on. As soon as I answer your question, then please quickly move on. This is what he would say. And suddenly these 4 people came and he said, it's haram, move on. They said, hang on, we did not ask our question. What is haram? He said, did you not 4 come from so and so village outside Baghdad? You decided yourselves that we will be asking this question about this animal, if it is haram or halal. Then I'm telling you the animal is haram. I have answered your question. Why are you now doubting me? Then they said, we were going to ask you this question. How do you know what we were going to ask? He said, if I cannot read your mind, then I'm not hujjat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm hujjat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because I know what you have planned. The hujjat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gifted. It is, he is special. Now he answered 16,000 questions in such a manner, and each and every person was satisfied, and most of those people converted to become the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam and the followers of Imam Muhammad Taqi alayhi salatu wasalam, and hence the followers of 12 Imams alayhi salam. Salawat.